So welcome, welcome back, guys. After the break, I hope it was refreshing.
Yes.
So, how many of you have been on flights?
Flights.
Almost everyone. So the next question will come after some time. So good morning, ladies and gentlemen, everyone present over here, respected jury members, faculty members, and all my fellow student managers. I, Sumeru, I have nothing to do with Meru Cabs.
And I, Abhishek, who have nothing to do with any flop movies,
are here to present. I'm here to give you the induction presentation from the river Sabarmati.
Let's have the video, please.
Thanda khana? I mean, what kind of a five-star hotel is this?
I'm sorry, sir.
Are you thanda khana?
All right, will you relax?
No, yaar, ek minute. You please call your chef.
Sir, please, I'll...
Please just call the...
Yes, sir, I'm the chef.
My friend was just saying...
Awesome! This biryani is superb.
Kuru khana?
Sometimes it's okay if you have a cold meal, but never when you fly. Enjoy delicious hot meals aboard SPICEJET flights.
So after watching this ad, how many of you want to fly with SPICEJET? Great. Good advertisement. So by now you have come to know that our presentation topic is on the turnaround of SPICEJET. Fasten your seatbelt, guys.
Okay, why this topic? It's a very amazing comeback story from the turmoil to the third largest aviation company in the Indian domestic airlines. Second one, our main objective is to show the positive attitude of SPICEJET as well as the right strategic move they've done in their last hours.
So coming on to the contents, we have introduction followed by the anatomy of crisis. Then we will show the resurgence of SPICEJET, the pillars of turnaround, the market share, market size, and the revenue. Then we have the competitors, followed by SWOT analysis, and finally the conclusion.
Okay, let's have an introduction. Established in 1994, named as Modi Lift, their main service was the air taxi service. After that, Indian entrepreneur Ajay Singh acquired the company in 2004 and renamed it as SPICEJET Limited. SPICEJET fleet size is 107, and in that, S400 Bombardier are 20 to 25 and others are Boeing 700 and 800. The number of employees working in SPICEJET currently is 8,447. Destination. Currently, SPICEJET has 35 domestic destinations and 6 international destinations. One of the recently, SPICEJET had made a big deal in an Indian domestic airline history with the American aviation company, which is of 1,50,000 crore with the American aviation company for about an order of 205 Boeing 737-8 aeroplanes. The tagline of SPICEJET is red, hot, and spicy.
So coming on to the anatomy of crisis, we have the fleet strategy. In this, they had a homogeneous fleet strategy which consisted of Boeing 737 flights. Then they moved away from the LCC norms and tried to bring in the Bombardier Q400, which added heterogeneity to their fleet. This resulted in addition of crew members to their flights and eventually rising in the salaries. Next, we have the route strategy. They often cancelled the routes and many of the destinations were terminated and they reduced the route size. We have screaming crude oil prices. That is at that point of time, due to the market imperfections, the prices went up for the crude oil and that hammered them a lot. And lack of internal consistency. This is followed by the fleet and route strategy where they should have followed their LCC norms, that is low cost carrier models, which they did not follow and moved away from their LCC norms. SpiceJet's resurgence. In this slide, we can see the revenue for SpiceJet for when they were going in losses. That is in 2012 and 2013, they were for 5,750 crores, they got the revenue, and it only went down in 2014 and 15 with 5,202 crores. The net profit also decreased as the year passed by, and it came back only in 2015-16 with the first quarter of being 22.5 and 72 crores respectively. This is the net profit.
Pillars of turnaround and strategy and serendipity. As my friend told about the low cost career model, their first strategic move towards when the loss happens was to bring the low cost career models. For that, they analyzed the route strategy and cut down the non-profitable destination. For this, they need to shut down 5 domestic and 3 international destination. Next is cost reduction through operational efficiency. For that, they fly their aeroplane through a light altitude and speed. Second one is a employment layoff, and third one is renegotiation with the strategic maintenance. Second is government support. At the time of 2014, SpiceJet was facing so much crisis in it. In that, government offered funds to the SpiceJet so that they helped them, and then it also banned it. Government also removed the ban of DCGA on selling the advance booking of tickets. Third one is fall in crude oil prices. This was a sudden stroke of luck for SpiceJet. At that time, the prices of oil were falling very drastically, which was helpful and favorable for the SpiceJet. Decoding the impact on profitability. Certain factors such as CASK, customer per available seat kilometer, PASK, profit available per seat kilometer, and RASK, revenue available per seat kilometer, were analyzed and inspected by the most impactful drivers of SpiceJet, which drove the SpiceJet into profit zone. Market size and share of the 2018. Total market size of the 2018, including all domestic airlines of India, was 62,464 crore. From that, SpiceJet share was 12.7%, which is 7,933 crores of the total amount.
So the major competitors are for SpiceJet are Jet Airways, Go Air, Indigo Airlines, and Air Asia. Specifically in the LCC models, Indigo and Go Air are the top competitors for SpiceJet.
SWOT analysis strength. The biggest strength for SpiceJet is their low cost carrier models. SpiceJet has largest number of LCC model. Second one is they have good presence in market due to good branding and advertising of their airlines, as well as interactive website. Their interactive website allows customer to book their tickets as well as hotels. Second one is weakness. As you can see, I told in introduction, there are only 41 destinations all around the world, including domestic. So to gain the profit, they need to expand their destination. Second weakness is low market share. Due to significant competent, their market share is very low. Third one is opportunities. SpiceJet is known for middle class peoples due to their low cost ticket fares. Second one is to tie up with international destination and setting up the new destination to create the brand image and profit in the market. Threats. One of the biggest threat for airlines is the rising prices of fuels, which is same for all airlines. Second one is strong competition. As you can see from the market share, Indigo was the nearly half the Indigo gained the nearly half of the market share of the domestic airlines.
coming on to the conclusion, strategy must be internally consistent, which they did not have. They moved away from the LCC norms, and that is why they were falling down in the market. The second is change of business model during oil price hikes led to more financial distress. They were unable to pay huge dues for the oil prices, which hammered them at the lowest point of their time.